Hello fashion sewers, in today's tutorial I'm going to be showing you how to put a boning into a seam. I'm Colleen Geely and this is Fashion Sewing Blog TV. This is a sewing project that I'm working on at the moment, and here in this channel I have a boning. And what boning is used for is to stiffen an area in a garment where you want vertical support. So if I bend this, you can see it actually springs back. And that boning will help because there's no support in the back of the dress. It'll help to keep the dress looking very upright. Here I have a strip of boning, and it's plastic boning. And as you can see, it is very flexible. Now if I bring it closer to the camera, hopefully you'll be able to see the actual texture and how it looks. And as I said, it is plastic. You can also get it in metal. And it's very rigid and stiff. Here I've got a sample of a seam. It's a plain seam. And I'm now making it a closed seam. And I'm pressing it in one direction. It can be either or. And what I'm going to do here is create a channel with this seam. So I'm going to be sewing about 3 to 4 millimeters along the raw edge here, and then the boning will channel through. I've now cut the required strip of boning that I need for my seam, and the edges on each side I'm going to round. Now in order to do that, you need your paper scissors, and you're going to just, it can be a bit tricky, and because you're working with plastic it can feel a bit stubborn, let's say. But as long as you try to get it as round as possible. The reason why we need it to be rounded is that it helps to stop it cutting away at the fabric once it's in the seam, and also to make sure that it doesn't also cut you as well when you're wearing the garment. So that should feel a lot more smoother than it does the other end, which I'm now going to round off. I'm still preparing our boning, and I've got a little bit of sticky tape, double-sided sticky tape, on the end of my thumb there, and I'm just going to put it on the rounded edge. There we go. And the reason why I'm doing that, I'm going to put a little piece of fabric just to cover that, so it gives a lot more protection from the sharpness of the curve. So I'm just going to get a little bit of fabric there, snip it off, and then just put it over the sticky tape, just to keep, the sticky tape's there just to keep it in place really, so it doesn't move, but this doesn't move about once it's in the seam. So there we are. I'm back to my seam sample here, and as you can see I've done my second row of stitching. It's quite a large stitch. I'm only doing this for demonstration purposes, so stick with your regular stitch. And there's now a channel created. I now have my boning, and I'm going to insert it into the channel. It can be a little bit tricky getting it started and in there. I'm going to turn my work around so that I can have a better view of what I'm doing and making sure that it is threaded through. And it can be a bit of a difficult job just to make sure you get it wriggled into there. So I've got it. Alright, that's quite a good job really. It can be a bit, right, so I'm happy with it there, and we're going to make sure that when it comes to the edge here, you don't want it anywhere near the edge, because you want to make sure that you've got your seam allowance for wherever you're joining the next seam. As you can see, I'm now making a comparison between the both. Remember, this is my sewing project that I've done, and I put it onto the lining, and this is the right side, as you can see here, and this is what it looks like on the wrong side. So inside here, this is what the wrong side looks like, and it is an absolute great piece of haberdashery to use for when you want that vertical stiffness is any kind of dresses that you do make, and also other garments.
I hope you found that video tutorial helpful. As regards with boning, you usually find it quite a lot in evening wear, where the dresses are usually backless, but they are in other parts of garments, such as coats and jackets, etc. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment box below, and I look forward to seeing you next time.